Hello friends, welcome to Doctor Squad. Today is our new topic is Pons. First, I will tell you one thing. Pons and cerebellum, both are the part of metaencephalon. The most common question asked by the teachers or in exam also, Pons and cerebellum. Pons and cerebellum are the part of metaencephalon. So here we go. First, this is a part of the brain. This is known as cerebrum. This is midbrain. This is pons. This is medulla oblongata, and this is cerebellum. Don't confuse with cerebrum to cerebellum. Okay, so today we will talk about this portion, and this portion is known as pons. Before starting the pons, there is a ventricle in joining with pons and cerebellum. Back of the pons there is a ventricle. That ventricle is known as fourth ventricle. It's like this. This whole part is known as fourth ventricle. Okay, now I am going to tell you the external features of pons. Okay, let's draw the pons. Here suppose think that it's a midbrain, then we are looking from the front side. Okay, and this is pons. It looks like this from the front side, and here will be medulla oblongata. If we look from the front side, the cerebellum will look like this. It's like this is fine. Okay, this is pons and cerebellum. If we look from this portion, cerebellum will look like this, but if we look in a front, then it will look like this. The same position that I draw here. Okay, first let's suppose this is left pons, this is right side of a pons. Both of these are divided by a sulcus. Here is one sulcus that divides pons into the two parts, right and left. This sulcus is known as sulcus basilaris. This sulcus is known as sulcus basilaris. There are three sulcus in pons. First sulcus is known as sulcus basilaris. The second sulcus is here, and this sulcus is known as superior pontine sulcus. How you will remember this sulcus? First, the Latin name of pons is pontine. Okay, it's on a superior side of a pontine, then it's known as superior pontine sulcus. The sulcus is known as superior pontine sulcus. If there is superior, then there will also be an inferior. Okay, then here we go for inferior sulcus, and this sulcus is known as sulcus bulbo pontine. Okay, this sulcus is known as sulcus bulbo pontine. How? Bulbo is a Latin name of medulla oblongata. And pons, Latin name of pons is pontine. So this sulcus is known as sulcus bulbo pontine. Why this sulcus is known as sulcus bulbo pontine? Because It separates medulla oblongata from the pons. Thus, let's revise. There are three sulcus: sulcus basilaris, sulcus pontine, sulcus superior, and sulcus bulbo pontine. Sulcus basilari is between pons, that divides pons into two parts: left pons and right pons. Sulcus pontine superior, it divides pons from the midbrain, and sulcus bulbo pontine, it divides pons to medulla oblongata. Okay, the most important thing that we have to remember is what is the connection between pons and cerebellum. Pons and cerebellum, it's the peduncle. Is the peduncle here? Is a peduncle in earlier photo video. I tell you, there is three peduncles here, here, and here. Okay, first, this peduncle is known as pedunculus cerebellaris medius. Peduncle cerebellaris medialis. It's a peduncle that connects pons with cerebellum. Here will be inferior and superior, and here will be the inferior one. It connects, inferior one connects medulla oblongata to the cerebellum, and superior one connects midbrain to the cerebellum. There are three peduncles that connects cerebellum to midbrain, pons, and medulla oblongata. The one and most important thing that the student get confused is here I will tell you the base and the two parts of pons. The first is base and second is tegmentum. Here we draw. This is cerebrum, midbrain, pons, medulla oblongata, and this is spinal cord, and this is cerebellum. Now, the pons is divided into two parts, base and tegmentum. Yeah, the tegmentum is also found in midbrain, but don't confuse with the tegmentum of midbrain and tegmentum of pons. Here is pons, right? Two parts. The back part is known as tegmentum. Tegmentum. And another part, this part is known as base. This part is known as base. Now I will tell you the fibers, corticopontine fibers. First I will tell you corticopontine fibers. Before that I will tell you there is one nucleus that found in a pons. There is one nucleus that found in a pons. I will tell you where it is located. Actually, here is our cerebrum, midbrain, pons, medulla oblongata. Here I will draw with another pen. Here is small nuclei, and this nuclei is known as pontine nuclei. That's why the pons is also known as pontine. Okay, now the first fibers that I want to tell you is the corticopontine fibers. First, corticopontine means the fiber starts from cortex of cerebrum. Here this part is cortex of cerebrum, right? From here the fiber starts, it goes to pontine nucleus. How will you know that corticopontine fibers come from cortex of cerebrum and goes to the pontine nuclei? It is in the name only. Corticopontine, cortico means cortex of cerebrum, pontine is the nucleus of a pons. So if you see anywhere corticopontine, then just remember that from the cortex of the cerebrum to the pontine nucleus. Here they start, like this, here they go to directly like this. This pathway from here like this, this pathway is known as corticopontine fibers. These are fibers that connects cortex to pons. There is another fiber that known as pontocerebellum, velar fibers, pontocerebellar. First ponto, pontine nucleus, cerebellar means somewhere, cerebellum, in cerebellum. Here, as you know, there is a peduncle. Yes, peduncle that connects pons with cerebellum. That's peduncle known as pedunculus cerebellis medialis. That peduncle is known as peduncle cerebral nucleus. Here, from pontine to cerebellum, means starts from pontine nucleus. They start from pontine nucleus like this, go from peduncle to the anywhere in cerebellum like this. These fibers known as pontocerebellar fibers. These fibers are known as pontocerebellar fibers. Okay, now I will tell you the another track is known. This track is known as rubrospinal track, but it is a part of a midbrain. But in some books they are also tell in a pons. So I will tell you in the pons only. Here I will draw midbrain from the cerebellum to midbrain like this. If we see from superior side, here is the cerebellum, interpeduncular fossa, right? Here is a midbrain. Okay, here is a pons, medulla oblongata, and here is a spinal cord. Pons, medulla oblongata, and spinal cord. Okay, here is a nucleus. In midbrain there is a nucleus. This nucleus is known as red nucleus. Red nucleus, as that's why I'll draw in a red color. So here we saw a two tracks. First, cortico-rubro track. Here is a cell in cortex, right? First, cortico rubro means from the cortex of a cerebellum to the rubro. The red nucleus is also known as rubro nucleus. So let's see how they go. Here, from the cortex to the red nucleus, cortex to the red nucleus, this track is known as cortico rubro track. From here also they go like this. Right, now from red nucleus to spinal cord, lateral culm of spinal cord. Okay, this track is known as rubrospinalis track. What this track is known as rubrospinalis track. Rubro, red nucleus, spinal track to the spinal cord like this. Some will go like that, this. This pathway is known as rubrospinal track, and this pathway is known as cortico-rubro track. It's really simple, isn't it? Okay, for today this is much. So hope you understand our pons, and if you have any doubt, tell us in a comment section. Like it, share it, subscribe it, and hope you all enjoy. Thank you.